Welcome to worship with Vermont Lutheran Church here in Black Earth, Wisconsin. We welcome you each week as we worship. The next two weeks, this week and next week, will still be done virtually. After that, on March 2nd, we will return to worshiping in the church in person, as we celebrate the beginning of our Lenten season. Until then, join us, and even after then, as I said, we will have the recordings on our website and on our YouTube page. So please, we welcome you back each and every week. And of course, if you would like more information about us or would like to contact us in any way, please see our webpage at www.vermontlutheran.org. So, let's begin our worship service for this week. We begin with our call to worship. Come to the living water. Come to Jesus' living water. Water that quenches thirst. Water that gives life. Come, worship and receive Jesus' gift of life. And we ask for God's forgiveness and confess our sinfulness. We confess our sinfulness to God and one another. Merciful God, Jesus shows us all the ways that we fall short. He also provides a way out of the holes we dig ourselves into. Forgive us our sins and show us how to make better choices, be better friends and parents, kids, partners, and co-workers. Let Christ's light shine through us. For the sake of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Jesus does indeed forgive us. Jesus cleanses us of our sin and recreates us in God's image. Receive the entire forgiveness of all your sins. Go and walk free of guilt and shame and sin, for you are made new. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And once more, let us pray our prayer for this day. God of all who thirst, you sent your Son Jesus to bring the living water of eternal life to all the earth. Quench the thirst of all who long for your word, your truth, and your presence, for the sake of him who gave everything to save all, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And then we have our text for this week from the book of John, the 7th chapter, beginning in verse 37. You'll have to excuse me a little bit this week. I'm having some video trouble getting that between the camera and online. And so today I will just be doing this verbally, and you can read along. And when it comes to the message, you can just enjoy the living water. So, our gospel reading for today, John 7, 37 to 52. On the last day of the festival, the great day, while Jesus was standing there, he cried out, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me, and let the one who believes in me drink. As the scripture has said, out of the believer's heart shall flow rivers of living water." Now he said this about the Spirit, which believers in him were to receive, for as yet there was no Spirit, because Jesus was not yet glorified. When they heard these words, some in the crowd said, "This is really the prophet." Others said, "This is the Messiah." But some asked, "Surely the Messiah does not come from Galilee, does he? Has not the scripture said that the Messiah is descended from David and comes from Bethlehem, the village where David lived?" So there was a division in the crowd because of him. Some of them wanted to arrest him, but no one laid hands on him. When the temple police went back to the chief priests and Pharisees, who asked them, "Why did you not arrest him?" the police answered, "Never has anyone spoken like this." And then the Pharisees replied, "Surely you have not been deceived too, have you? Has any one of the authorities or the Pharisees believed in him? But this crowd, which does not know the law, well, they are accursed. Nicodemus, who had once gone to Jesus before and who was one of them, asked, "Our law does not judge people without first giving them a hearing to find out what they are doing, does it?" And they replied, "Surely you are not also from Galilee, are you? Search, and you will see that no prophet is to arise from Galilee." This is the word of our Lord. Grace and peace be yours through our Lord Jesus Christ, the source of living water. Amen. On Saturday morning, our two cats were bothering Ingrid and I something awful. They wouldn't leave the bathroom sink, up on top of the bathroom sink, that is. Now, when we first got them, our kitties would jump up on the sink, and me, being the absolute marshmallow that I am when it comes to animals, would put the stopper in the sink and some water in it, and the kitties would come and drink. Now, Ingrid, being the more sensible part of the couple that we are, saw an end to this practice because she was tired of fighting for space at the sink for the kitties in the bathroom, wise woman that she is. And so we went out from having a bowl out in the kitchen to having one of those nice fountain top sort of waters that cats find more attractive and would be more interested in drinking from. Well, and this morning we had evidently left the water too long without changing, and the cats now decided that they would rather go back to drinking fresh water from the kitchen, or from the bathroom sink. I solved the problem by cleaning out their water dish and replacing their water, and once more everyone was happy. It wasn't an earth-shattering event, but it reminded me of this week's text reading, and so once again I started over for my message with you this week. Now, if you have cats, you'll know that they like water, but they prefer that water to be moving. Some experts say it has something to do with being able to see the water, because as a clear liquid, they have a hard time finding where the barriers, the parameters of the water is, huh? Some say that the clear liquid might be difficult for them to see plainly. And some say it has something to do with the fact that it's a little bit more entertaining for the cats if it's moving and gives them something to play with as well as drink. And if you have any experience with having an animal around the home, you'll know that water cannot just sit in a bowl for a very long time without becoming somewhat stale, huh? And then things begin to grow in the water, which makes it also unpleasant to drink. At this time of year, you know how refreshing it is to pour a nice cold glass of water from the tap in order to drink it as we enjoy the cool waters of Wisconsin winters, huh? Cats, it seems, aren't any different than we are. We wouldn't rather drink from a glass of water that's been left to sit on the counter overnight. Instead, we go to the sink and get a fresh glass of running cold water, which is more refreshing. In this week's text, Jesus said, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me, and let the one who believes in me drink. As the scripture had said, out of the believer's heart shall flow rivers of living water." Jesus refers to his offering us a living water, not water that is from a stagnant pool that, while it might meet our daily need, is not as refreshing to drink and does not soothe us and re-energize us as living water is. In the region where Jesus preached, there were two seas, one that was called the Dead Sea. It was considered dead because nothing could survive in those heavily salt-laden waters, except for maybe some smaller things that are difficult to see in the water. But nearby was the Sea of Galilee, which was thriving and teeming with life. The main difference for the two is that the water in the Sea of Galilee flowed freely, while water flowing into the Dead Sea pooled there with no outflow. In other words, the sea that ceased to move water was considered dead. Well, when preaching, Jesus spoke, and he said, "Let anyone who is thirsty come to me." He invited people who desired more for their lives to come and follow him. Jesus then quoted scripture, "Out of the believer's heart shall flow rivers of living water." Living water, refreshing water, water that gives more to the life, more than life to the body. It also feeds our souls. If living water is water that moves, and if living water comes from a believer's heart, then followers of Jesus rise to the occasion when they too move and flow. To be a follower is to act, huh? To follow. Now, we speak about being the hands of God working in the world. The ELCA has latched onto this phrase to emphasize that we as disciples are motivated to use the gifts that we have been given under God's wonderful direction, to do God's work in the world. Faith that doesn't act itself out can easily become a stagnant faith, just as water becomes stagnant when it doesn't move for any length of time. Learning, acting, helping, moving, we energize our faith when we put it to use, especially when we use it to feed and energize others. Martin Luther was uncomfortable with the New Testament book of James, mostly because it included things like in chapter 2, James writes, what good is it, my brothers and sisters, if you say you have faith but do not have works? Can faith save you? If a brother or sister is naked and lacks daily food, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm and eat your fill, and yet you do not supply their bodily needs, what good is that? So faith by itself, if it has no good works, is dead. Well, Martin objected to that, mostly because the popes and the priests of his time were making people prove their faith by working for the church. They had to perform some acts of contrition, some pretty severe acts of contrition, and contributing financially to the church often beyond when they had the means to do so. These acts, they said, were to prove a person's faith through acts of sacrifice. Luther condemned these practices, saying no one needs to prove their faith, and the only one that people need to convince is God, not the Pope. But James was not entirely wrong about acting out our faith, for faith without works is like water that doesn't move. Slowly, the faith lacks its ability to refresh and to bring joy, and rather becomes nothing more than a piece of bread to nourish the body that yearns for steak and potatoes, not bread, and cool, flowing water, not stagnant water in an old kitty dish. Many who heard Jesus didn't like what he had to say. Leaders were threatened by his words and also by his actions. Jesus wasn't one to remain stagnant. He didn't have a home. He didn't have a house of his own to live in. He kept moving. He was the living water. Jesus was alive, active, moving, flowing, changing the world. And we are invited to believe and to follow and flow with rivers of living water as well. We too are invited to act, to flow, to change the world. We are called to be living waters, no matter where we're from. If it's Galilee or Bethlehem Black Earth or Mesomany or Cross Plains or Mount Horeb or the village of Vermont, huh? It doesn't matter. Jesus calls us to flow with the living waters. Let us pray. refreshing God. Through your inspiration and love, you encourage us to move forward and refresh others. Give us strength and courage to fill others with your living water, that they too may know the joy of being alive in your love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And realizing that every day we live as an offering to our Lord, let us pray together our offertory prayer. Living water, receive these gifts that we offer to you as a sign of our devotion to the one who gives life. Multiply these gifts so that your water may flow abundantly throughout the world. Amen. And we pray the prayers of the church and for the people of the world. Confident in your abundant grace, we pray for the church, the world, and all those who are in need. God, giver of life, your Son Jesus risked everything to bring your word of life to people who were slow to receive him. Open our hearts so that we may receive your word and your truth with humility and grace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Let rivers, lakes, streams, oceans, ponds, and wells deliver clean water to all who are in need. Help us to make your earth sustainable for all who depend on it for life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grant wisdom and mercy to all who lead. Grant trust and peace to all who follow. Grant faith to all who place their lives in your hands. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Pour out your healing waters upon all who suffer in all areas of life. For those who mourn, are hungry, homeless, neglected, alone, abused, addicted, imprisoned, or ill. Especially as we pray for Marie Severson at this time, asking that you give her patience and comfort in her days of sorrow and pain. Lift her up as well as her family. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Show us the brilliant colors of the diversity in this world. Help us to appreciate our differences and celebrate all that makes us unique. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With your saints, we marvel at your unending persistence as you continue to pursue us and call us by name. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Grateful for your everlasting faithfulness, we lift our hearts and our prayers to you, merciful God, in the name of your Son, Jesus the Christ. Amen. And we have a litany for this week. Loving God who quenches thirst with living water, each and every day we can see evidence all around us that your heart beats loud and strong in this world. When we wake and there is fresh air for our lungs and food for our bodies, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When a baby is born and she is given her first taste of mother's milk, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When our waste is composted or recycled, and our carbon footprint is left more gently upon the earth for future generations, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When a child is spared from abuse, neglect, isolation, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When a voice that has been silenced is heard, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When a couple struggling with infertility brings home a child through adoption, surrogacy, or fertility treatments, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When a well is dug in the center of a remote village on the far side of the world, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When someone has been unemployed brings home their first paycheck, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When someone is freed from addiction and blessed with a new life in recovery, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. When we lay our heads on our pillows each night, having accomplished what we have accomplished and having let go what we have not, we drink deeply. Living water, pulse of life. Open our eyes to see your fingerprints all over our beautiful, colorful lives. Amen. And now may the source of all living water flow in you. May the refreshment of the living water flow through you. And may the joy of serving the living water be with you always. Amen. Thank you again for joining us. I want to make sure and give credit to Keith and Kristen Getty, G-E-T-T-Y, whose YouTube video we used for our hymn for this week. And we invite you back next week once again as we join virtually for our, hopefully the last time for a while, as we return to worship in church and on the 2nd of March. But know that we will record services all the same and bring them to you here. Thank you for joining us, and may God bless you as you flow with living water. Amen.